Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A transgender teaching assistant forced to quit her job after appearing in pornography could be thrown out of the profession by a tribunal. Dr. Robyn Williams failed to appear at a fitness to practise hearing today run by the Education Workforce Council at Ewloe. Dr. Williams, who previously worked at Llandrillo College at Rhos-on-Sea in North Wales, is accused of posing for 16 indecent to pornographic pictures intended for publication in an adult magazine. She also faces another allegation that the photos were posted on Twitter. Teaching assistant Dr. Robyn Williams, pictured left and right, could be struck off at a fitness to practise hearing after being accused of appearing in pornography. David Phillips, health and safety manager at Llandrillo College, told the panel Dr. Williams had been employed 10 years and was initially approached by two female administrators about the images in April 2016. Mr. Phillips said, staff members were saying, "I don't think this is proper, it's disgusting, it makes my stomach turn." He told the panel, a video on a Twitter feed showed Dr. Williams naked and there was graphic text. Mr. Phillips said the video was obscene, and showed her lying on a bed, talking to a camera and getting ready for sex. He added, "I didn't wish to view any further." The panel was told Dr. Williams resigned from the college. In a blog post written before the hearing, Dr. Williams, also known as Jane, accused colleagues at the school of discriminating against her. She also said she was subject to prejudice because she was transgender. Dr. Williams wrote, "Both my partner and I are no strangers to the visual disapproval and comments of other women as we seek to do everyday things like using the loo, try on clothes, or hold hands in public." In North Wales, while working as a teaching assistant, female colleagues made complaints to management, forbidding me from using female toilets and changing rooms. Earlier, as a single mum taking my 11-year-old daughter to A&E, I was repeatedly questioned by a staff nurse about my right to be identified as her parent and go with her into the examination room. A later FOI request revealed she had reported concerns to social workers about a child accompanied by a man dressed as a woman. At work I was called a freak and an offense against nature. My locker was defaced with sentiments suggesting I should die. Last year, on our way to a pride event, a van was driven at my partner and I, forcing us to scatter while the driver hurled abuse from his window. When she wrote to the EWC, Dr. Williams said, "I don't believe my behavior constituted unacceptable professional conduct. I didn't post or upload any of the images and the account on which they appear isn't my Twitter account." She said images had been taken of her in 2015 for a top shelf men's magazine. "Some of those images seem to have made their way online," she stated. Dr. Williams, pictured, did not attend the hearing but wrote in a blog post that she endured prejudice and discrimination during her former job. Dr. Williams said she worked as a photographic model before she was registered with the EWC and never mixed her jobs. "With hindsight, I can see my actions may have been inappropriate," she wrote. "I am deeply regretful of any offense caused. I feel I did the right thing in tendering my resignation." She said she had been celebrating my femininity and declared, "As a feminist woman, I am deeply opposed to pornography. Erotic imagery celebrates the beauty of the human body. I posed for erotic and not explicit images." Dr. Williams said she had become a highly successful businesswoman running a catering business. She didn't wish to return to education work. Samantha McIlvogue, director of learning services, said Dr. Williams supported students aged from 16. The Twitter feed had a mock-up tabloid image of Dr. Williams with her nipples showing, one of her in the bath, and a third of her on a bed wearing a leopard print garment. Dr. Williams told her pictures had been taken as part of a modeling job. Mr. Phillips said the images he'd seen were pretty grim. Dr. Williams's conduct was alleged to have displayed a lack of integrity. The hearing continues.